Hey, what's up everyone? In this quick tutorial, I want to show you how to create a realistic glass material in cycles. So I have this object here that has this material, which as you can see, it's blank. And let's add a glass shader and plug it into our surface output and see how it looks. So as you can see, it does have some reflections and shininess to it, but it doesn't look like glass. So what I usually do is I add a transparent shader. So let's add a transparent shader here, and I mix these two with a mix shader, and it already looks a lot more like glass. And we can actually render that again. So as you can see, it already looks so much more like glass now, but it kind of feels empty and thin, as if it's a light bulb. And if you're making a light bulb, it's probably perfect, but for other glass objects, like this one, which is a ball made of glass, we want to feel its thickness. So what we want to do is here, we only have these shaders for the surface that you know, takes care of the reflections and everything, but what we need is to add a volume to our material, so that when the light photons pass through this object, they get absorbed and scattered, and you know, they get affected by the glass. So what I usually do is I add a volume absorption, and let's make a little room here, and I set its density to somewhere around like 0.4 maybe, and I make it black, and as you can see, it kind of gives it a little more depth, but I also like to add a volume scatter, so a volume scatter, and I give it a density of let's say 2, a little more than 2 maybe, let's just leave it at 2 for now. And for this other thing, which I have trouble pronouncing, anisotropy, we give it something like 0.8. And we also make this black, and we're going to add these two shaders using an add actually we should use add shader, not a math add, but an add shader. So let's add these two shaders and plug it into the volume. Let's see how that looks like in the render. So as you can see, it no more looks like a light bulb, and it looks a lot thicker, as if this whole thing is made of glass. And as you can see, we have a little more of shadow on the floor compared to this. That's because light gets absorbed while going through our glass. And you can see that a lot better with tinted glass. So we can give this glass a tint, and you will see that the light that goes through it gets affected. And to do that, you can change these two colors. We are absorbing black. If we absorb like this, we'll get, let's try something like this. Maybe like this, something like that. Something like that looks looks cool. If we render this again, I have my samples very low because I'm recording the screen, but if you do this with a higher sample, it will look a lot better. So if you pay close attention, you can tell that our shadow is now tinted. You know, our semi-transparent shadow here, it is tinted, as you can tell. And actually, my camera's view is not, you know, you're not really seeing that much of this semi-transparent shadow here, but I can assure you that when light passes through this tinted glass, the shadow will also be tinted. So you will not have that realistic looking effect if you you know, just tint the surface, but now we're tinting the volume. So it's like this ball right here, it's made of a tinted glass. It's not like a glass that is being painted over. So yeah, here's a quick comparison between this, which is just the glass shader, and this is glass shader plus transparent shader. They're added to each other using a mixed shader node. And this one right here, this one has those volume shaders applied to it, and as you can see, it looks a lot thicker and a lot more realistic than this one. And you can also give it a tint and make it look like this. So if you get a better view here, you can see here we get that. Actually, let me try to kind of make it like this. And now here, as you can see, the light that passes through gets tinted. So that is it for this video. Don't forget to drop a comment down below, and I will see you next time.